Are you still thinking if Swift is the right language for building out iOS apps? Well, the answer is a definite yes. Alex here from Rebeloper.com. I want you to hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. Today, I'm not going to talk about why you should use Swift and why it is such a good idea to use it in iOS development. Rather yet, I will talk about some of the lesser known or lesser used Swift components that are so super awesome, I have to talk about them in this tutorial. So, we are going to talk about error handling and Codable. So let's just start off with error handling and go ahead and click the link down below for the resources so you can start off with this playground. If not, then go ahead and just type out what I already have in here. It's not that much. So first of all, we have an enum of an error that is called validation error, and one is too short, one is too long, and invalid character found with a parameter of character. Now what we are going to do is just validate some usernames, and for that we are just going to create a user did pick name. Let's say we added a string here, and then we are going to validate it, and as you can see there is some strange thing here, froze, that we are going to touch in just a moment, and we are going to extend this validation error with localized errors. Okay, so that's it for our error handling startup, and finally we are going to use did pick name as Alex, and we're going to try out some other stuff too. So let's start off by validating our username, and what we are going to do is first of all check if it's too short and if it's too long or it has any invalid characters. So let's just type it guard username dot count. And if it's greater than 3, then we are going to pass it along. We are not going to throw any errors, and make sure that you have this froze after your function. Else, we are going to throw. And we are going to throw our validation error dot too short. Okay, so that's that. Now we want to go ahead and go for our too long version. So guard username dot count, and let's say we want to make it shorter than, let's say, 15 characters. Else, we are going to again throw our validation error dot too long. Okay, now comes the tricky part. We want to take a look if there is any invalid characters in the username. So for that, we are going to just iterate through the username characters, and we are just going to check one by one if that is an invalid character. Okay, so let's say for character in username, and now we are going to guard character, and we are going to use isLetter. Else, let's just throw our error. So validation error dot and invalid character, and the character is that character. Okay, so let's just go ahead and go and do that. So let's just validate our username inside the user did pick name. And that is pretty straightforward. Just type in validate. And as you can see, it throws an error if there is an error. So username is username. And while this could be it, it will say can call can throw, but it is not marked with try. So what we are going to do is add it into a block of a do block, and then we are going to try to call this validate, and if there are any errors, we are going to check it out. So we're going to just check for those. So do, and we are going to catch here, and for the catch statement, we are just going to print out the error. So
print.
In the do block, we are going to try and say validate our user name. And basically that is it. Let's just go ahead and build till this user did pick name. And we should have some, we are going to just, let's say, print out our username so we can see that indeed we did validate that username. So let's just build that again. And as you can see, it has been printed out. Now, let's see if this would be like L, like two characters. Let's build that again. And we will see that it is too short. Now, again, this isn't quite of a good explanation for our error, but we will figure that out later. And let's say we will have a strange character like an at here, and let's just build it out. And first of all, it is too short, so let's make it like 5 characters. And building it, it says invalid character found and that at sign. Of course, for the too long, it will be the same. Now, let's just finally create our extension for our debug description. So create a var, and that is our error description. And as you can see, it is an optional string. And we are going to switch through all of our values of ourself, because yeah, this is an extension of our local, our error here. And if it is, let's see, too short, then we are just going to return here an NS localized. For the key, we are going to, let's say, type it out, your username. And for the comment, we're just going to leave that out. And let's do the same for the too long. Just copying and pasting that out. Too long, there we go. Your username must be shorter than 15 characters. Okay. And finally, we are going to use, let me just select all of this and hit Control I. And the final case is invalid characters found, and the character will be a let character here. So now let us just create our format. So let format equals ns localized string, and let's add in here these special signs so we can interpolate that character, and we will just use that. And finally, we are going to return our string with format. So that is what we are going to return if there is an invalid character found. So let's just build and run again, and let's see if we do get back these localized descriptions. Okay, now that we have that out of the way, I just figured that we need to do this with an at sign. So that's how it should look like. And now, finally, let's add our localized description to our error. Okay, let's just build that out. And we should see that your username must not contain this at parameter. That's really, really nice. And let's just see the other one. We would have only 2 characters there. Your username must be longer than 3 characters. How awesome is that? Okay, that's it for error handling. I hope you now really understand how you can make your own custom errors. Now, let's talk a little bit about Codable. Now, Codable is actually a type alias that combines 2 protocols, and that is Encodable and Decodable into one. Now, why do you want to use that? That is because, let's say you are fetching some JSON files from the web and you want to encode them or decode them. So what we are going to do here is just go ahead and add Codable to this user struct. And let's just do and catch if there will be any errors. If there will be any errors, we are just going to print out Let's say, let's just print out our error. I don't really care. That will be a JSON decodable error. Now, in the do statement, we want to basically encode and then decode our user. So first of all, let's create our user. Let's say a user here. And that will be, let's say, Alex, age 36. Okay, now we want to encode this as a JSON encodable. So first of all, let's create our encoder here. And that is JSON encoder. So now what we want to do is create a data. So let data equals, and we're going to try it because it may throw an error. So try encoder, encode, and user. And that's it. Basically, that is it. Now we will have a data that we can use. So let's just print out our data for now. So print data. So we know that we really did that. Okay, so let's just veer this out and see what we got. Okay, 24 bytes, that is okay. Now let's just decode this data. And for that, we are just going to create a decoder. So let decoder, let's say you fetched all of this data from the web and you just create a JSON decoder for that. And what you want to do is just create a let second user equals decoder decode. And here we have a type, and for that we are just going to use self.user and from the data, and that is our data. Okay, and finally let's just print out our second user. Okay, let's just build this out. Oh, I need to have user.self here. Okay, and that will most probably work. Oh, and we want to have a try here, so let's just add in here a try. And because we are in a do block, try will be A-OK. So now that we know that the 24 bytes is our data, we can safely see that our decoded user is their name, Alex, and age 36. Now, how awesome was that? Just a few lines of code and you can decode and encode all of your data. I really hope that now you can see that Swift is the way to build out iOS apps. Now, I want you to hit that notification bell because in my next video, I will be talking about how you can start learning to build your very own iOS apps. Now, in the meantime, while you wait for that, make sure to check out these two videos as well. I talk a lot about iOS development and, of course, Swift UI. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.